Hello and welcome back to my channel. So if you're joining me today, thank you and welcome. I have a cozy cup of tea here. Grab yourselves a nice drink and we'll begin. So today I'm going to be showing you some Valentine's crafts and also like home decor pieces for Valentine's that you can relatively easily make. They're super simple, won't break the bank, and just make your home that much more festive and cozy for Valentine's, month of February, not just for Valentine's. So, got this basket here to Lena, just so you can see a little better, and I've got this like a heart wreath shape. I've had this quite some time. I bought it in a charity shop ages ago. I've used it for so many different Christmas wreaths, spring wreaths, so it's got quite a bit of, you can see it's got still got quite a bit of hot glue on the back, but that's fine because you can take things off and reuse it, and it's held up really well. So what I'm doing is super simple. I've literally, it's my hot glue on, yep. I have this sparkly red rose. I want to say I picked this up actually at Christmas time, or just after Christmas in Home Bargains. Anyway, it's really beautiful. Look how it sparkles. And it did obviously come on a long stem with leaves and whatnot, but for the purpose of this, I have already taken that off. And for the sides, I have some faux eucalyptus pieces that I'm going to use, and a bow that I have already made out of this jute ribbon and this cotton red and white striped ribbon. Neither of these ribbons are wired, they're just completely flat. And so I have threaded, like if you can see here and underneath, I have threaded florist wire through them to hold the structure, and then also to allow me to move them around pieces around and like fluff them out. I'll make another one and show you how I did it. It's really simple. I'll do one now, quickly, just to show you. So, shall we do one? We'll do one with this. Right, so I've got this jute ribbon. Just cut off however much you need. I'm not going to make this too big. Right, where are my wire clips? And then take your florist wire and your wire clips and cut off a small amount. So here's my piece of florist wire and my ribbon. And so I'm just going to begin. Open up the ribbon and fold it over in loops, so there's one, and then kind of like go back over. Not very good at explaining this, but if you can see what I'm doing, it's kind of easier to explain, like to show someone rather than tell them. I've kind of just like folded it over in loops. Now, I'm going to take my florist wire. Now, if this was just cotton ribbon, like this for example, you can't really put the florist wire through it, and you can only put it through because the jute string ribbon, the jute ribbon has obviously got little like holes in it. So if you're using any other ribbon, you'd need to like wrap the florist wire around the whole of your bow, like around all the loops underneath, and then like spin this part at the back around like that. But because this is jute ribbon, we can take your florist wire, holding all of your loops firmly in one hand, thread the florist wire through like so, and then go back again over on the other side, obviously leave a gap in between. Thread it back through, so then you've created a little loop there and both of your pieces are back here. Now this is the part where the bow really takes effect. You've just literally got to play around with the placement of the little loops that you've created, pull them up, twist them around to make a little bow. Now this isn't the best, but you get what I'm trying to do so quickly on here. And then whilst you're left with these pieces, you can make a smaller one like I have and stick that on top. Obviously if you've used a bigger piece of ribbon, you'd make more loops. But you can really play around with it. And then skewer at the back by twisting the florist wire around, and then you can actually use the bit that you threaded through, the jute ribbon, to attach it to your wreath form, or I don't know, a jar maybe, if you were decorating it as like a little gift. Yeah, so that's that. That was the ribbon. Right, so I'm just going to begin by taking my wreath form, and I think I'm just going to put it I was just going to put it on one side because I really like the texture in the wreath, so I think I'm just going to do it on one side again. If you've seen me make wreaths before, you will have noticed that I do that quite a lot. My little clips through. We're just going to trim back some of this stem, and you can just thread some of it through the wreath form to kind of get it in the place that you want, and then go in with your hot glue and glue it in place with the leaves so the leaves stay down. It's really very simple, and what you want is the leaves to be obviously all the same way around. My little stem has come off a little. Mind not to worry. You can glue it back on. It's a bit tricky to do it on this wreath form, these bigger pieces of eucalyptus, because of the crisscrossing of the willow and the stem in this eucalyptus is really very flimsy, so it's not holding up very well. Around and play with the placement of the leaves. Let's see. I want this wall at the top. I really love making the wreath. If you've been watching my videos recently, you will know that I literally make a wreath for every occasion. And I already have plans for spring and Easter. It just brings joy, doesn't it, to see it on your front door? glue just gets everywhere. Really like this eucalyptus, but tricky to work with on here. Need some more glue. Trim that little bit of stone down. Make it a bit easier, I think, to glue to set. There we go. Right, now. I feel like I do need a few more leaves. Maybe we can place the flower on an angle perhaps. If I can thread it through here. This is why it's a little bit more malleable than the stems of the eucalyptus. And it might blend in a whole lot better. There's the blue feathers. I might just reposition this one leaf over here. Oh! I got from the glue fibers absolutely everywhere. I am very pleased with this. Right, so I have managed to secure the flower, the rose, on with its stem alone, but I think I will need to go in with some glue as well. Okay, that sticks. So here we have it so far. Now, I do want to put the ribbon on. Well, I'm just wondering where, and I feel like I need to move a couple of these leaves off a little bit. I've literally used, I don't even think that was like one whole pick of eucalyptus I set aside for this, and I didn't go out and buy anything new. I just like shop from my home. See, no, it's really really simple but very effective. I am very pleased with that, and I will be changing this up on my door. I think do I want to put that there? Yeah, do I want to put the door? do we think? Here, perhaps? Maybe at the bottom? It's quite tricky. Let's see. I'll probably put it on, secure it, and then decide, oh, I don't like it. Do we think? I mean, I like it, but I'm in two minds about the bow. We'll see. I may just pop it up and then obviously I can take it off if I change my mind about it, but there we have it. That is my simple Valentine's wreath. Yeah, so I hope you like this along with my other craft that you'll see shortly. And if you did, please consider hitting this little button. And thanks for watching. I hope you are creating also, because it's such a relaxing activity. It's a mindful activity. It really helps you like to de-stress after your day. And yeah, it's good to be creative, isn't it? It's just such a good outlet. So I hope this inspires you also to let out your creative side. And even if you're not quite into Valentine's, I mean, I don't go all out and celebrate it, but I do love to decorate seasonally and change things up. And as I said, it just brings me joy to see things like this throughout my home. I've created it myself, nobody else has one. It's something filthy to fill your home with. So yes. Enough of my rambling. I hope you come back and watch some more videos, and I'll see you all soon. Thank you. Bye now. Bye. So I just wanted to come on and show this heart that I made. It's basically some wooden beads threaded onto florist wire and painted. They're shaped into a heart shape, and then I made a ribbon to pop on it and to decorate it with. It's really simple. I had hoped that I'd have enough wooden beads to make another version of this just to show you, but it's really self-explanatory. I got the wooden beads from, where did I pick them up? Amazon. The ribbon I already had, and the florist wire, so quite an expensive little craft. And here on our little tree, one of my sons also painted some beads and made them into little hearts, a green and a blue one. And he really enjoyed the activity, sitting threading the beads onto the florist wire, painting them. I actually painted the beads on the heart after I'd threaded the heart. I mean, it might have been easier to ensure they were all covered, painting them beforehand, popping them on, I don't know, maybe a skewer. Painting them all, letting them dry, then threading them, but whatever way works best for you. Yeah, I think I'll definitely get some more of these and make some more decorations with it. My Valentine's decor.